Jason and Sarah are like any other college sophomores.
We're so
horny. By the looks of it, Jason's barking up the right tree. But then, a vision appears.
Check this out.
Across the campus green, something draws them like moths to a flame. A giant basketball. A leftover from yesterday's pep rally.
Yeah. You have to get inside of this thing.
The perfect place for a once-in-a-lifetime quickie. Sarah finds the way in and pulls its zipper down faster than Jason's fly. A peek inside leads to a surprising discovery.
This is so cool!
Their party balloon is filled with helium.
Go in.
Oh, yeah.
Once inside their laughing gas chamber, Sarah and Jason are feeling no pain.
The thing we get when we go in the operating room. So they're actually going under anesthesia, slowly getting anesthetized, shutting down brain function. At the same time, they're asphyxiating. And it's going to slowly produce a disordered neurotransmission in the brain and shut higher order centers in the brain off.
At first, it's all fun and games. But after a while, their lightheaded helium buzz becomes something else. Something a lot worse.
I feel so weird.
Yeah. I think we should probably get some air really quick.
These two college kids should have hit the books a little harder.
Yeah.
A helium-only environment might be fun to play in. You just can't live in it. Jason and Sarah spend their last moments disoriented, unable to find the magic zipper. Finally succumbing to the lack of oxygen. Once they locked themselves inside their funhouse, it was only a matter of time before their fun turned to none. Most guys from Texas, JT would rather be out drinking with his buddies than doing yard work. But he was no match for his smoking hot wife, Trixie.
Oh, I gotta go. Oh, Trixie, ma'am. Just taking a little water break here's all.
Do you like what you had last night?
Oh, hell yeah, I do.
Are you horny for this right here?
Yeah, baby, I'm horny for some of that.
All right, well, put your singer away and get rid of that hornet's nest. Do it.
You're my queen.
Threatening to turn off the Mickey nozzle was more than JT could bear. It was time to go to war.
All right, I'm doing my business. Come on, come on.
There are a few hundred hornets in this nest. You have to understand that insects do an important job in nature, whether they're harmful to us because we make the mistake of disturbing their nest or being in a place that they want to be.
Come on!
JT was striking out with the hornets, but this was Texas. When all else fails, hit the gun rack. Being more of a suburban cowboy, JT came back out clutching his weapon of choice, a paintball gun.
Think you can come between me and the sanctimony of humping my wife? Well, eat paint, buggo!
Yeah! Oh, yeah! Who's the man?
JT should have thought first and shot later. When threatened, hornets mobilize their entire nest to sting in defense. The first hornet in sprays him with an alarm pheromone. The other hornets use the scent of the pheromone to zero in on their target. Now, JT didn't know a lot about anything, including himself. For example, he had no idea he was allergic to bee venom. He had a severe reaction called anaphylaxis. and collapsed, covered with welts from hundreds of hornet stings. What this means is his blood vessels dilated, causing a drop in blood pressure. The airway to his throat and lungs became swollen, making breathing impossible. He quickly went into shock and never recovered. JT died a noble gunman, fighting for the booty rights to his Texas maiden. Happy trails, cowboy.